You've been listening to the Bourbon Street Dixieland Combo play when my sugar walks down the street. All the birdies go tweet, tweet, tweet. It's a 1920s jazz standard written by Gene Austin, Jimmy McHugh, and Irving Mills in 1924. Who's Sorry Now is a popular song with music written by Ted Snyder and lyrics by Burt Calmer and Harry Ruby. It was published in 1923. When Isham Jones took it to number three in 1957, it was recorded by Connie Francis, and since then, the song has become closely identified with her due to the immense popularity of her version, which was her breakout hit. The last tune was the Muskrat Ramble. It's a jazz composition written by Kid Orley in 1926. It was first recorded on February 26th. Of 1926 by Louis Armstrong and his Hot Five, and became the group's most frequently recorded piece. It was a prominent part of the Dixieland Revival repertory in the 1930s and 40s, and was recorded by Bob Crosby, Roy Eldridge, Lionel Hampton, Woody Herman, Muggsy Spanier, Chet Atkins, Lou Waters, the Andrews Sisters, Harry James, and Al Hurt, among others. It is considered a part of the jazz standard repertory. You have a little time now until we bring in the big band for our concert. We have a couple of sheets available to you at the entrances. If you are not already on the mailing list or on our email list, you can fill out one of these little forms and leave it at the door, even at the doors, and we'll put you on our mailing list. Also, if you're so moved that you would like to make a contribution, we have an envelope at the available at each of the doors, and you can put lots of money in there. We'll be starting the program in about 5 minutes, so we have time for a leg stretch for a minute. And then... Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 30th anniversary spring concert of your Oshkosh Area Community Band. My name is Tom Dowman, and it's a pleasure to serve as your announcer this evening. Our director has selected a wonderful variety of pieces from the past 30 years that we think will entertain you, and new pieces that will enrich you. At this point, we would like to make some comments about our director. He and his wife, Amy, Mr. Hathaway, have given many, many years of devotion to this band. They have promoted it in every possible way. They've drawn others to help them in building the band trailer and the parade trailer and moving around these risers that you see the band sitting on. They have served, Amy has served us as the treasurer since day one, and I understand from Amy that she learned that when Terry came home from the first election of the officers of the band and announced to her, guess what, you're the treasurer. Ladies and gentlemen, we are very appreciative of our director and the fine job that he has done. Would you please join with the band in welcoming our director, Mr. Terry Hathaway. Based on Marc-Antoine Carpentier's Te Deum, our opening selection was commissioned for the 1991 European Brass Band Championship held in Rotterdam, Holland. The symphonic band version that you're going to hear tonight seemed appropriate for tonight's 30th anniversary concert. Here is Fanfare and Flourishes for a festive occasion. Our second piece is a wonderful piece of band music I'm sure that you're going to thoroughly enjoy. Before the Beatles, the Sousa Band, the John Philip Sousa Band, was the first musical organization to travel more than a million miles and perform for more than a million people. The band's tours were worldwide, including a performance in the Oshkosh Grand Opera House. With the possible exception of the Stars and Stripes Banner, or the Star Spangled Banner, no musical composition has done more to arouse the patriotic spirit of America than this, John Philip Sousa's most beloved composition. Written on Christmas Day in 1896, here is the ever-popular Stars and Stripes Forever.
Thank you.
program that way. We're opening your program that way. Well, where are we going to go from there? John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes version. The battle hymn of the Republic is deeply embedded in American tradition, musical, patriotic, and religious. The music came into national prominence as one of the earliest of the great inspirational songs of the Civil War. However, the melody was well known to many Americans long before the war between the states. In 1850, it was already included in a number of church hymnals. During the past century, the song has been increasingly accepted as part of the American tradition. The melody, with its strength and dignity, makes it a universal expression of noble aspirations of all people. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy now the Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Thank you.
The next selection is a piece of musical history for the band, featuring a trumpet trio. It is the only piece that Terry can be positive that was played at the band's very first concert 30 years ago. On the Showmobile at South Park at the Art Fair in June of 1988. Even better is the fact that Mary Morelli performed in the trio 30 years ago and is playing it again tonight. Featuring Molly DeKaiser, Mary Morelli, and Mark Hammond, here for your delight is Bright Eyes. Mary would like you to know that 30 years ago, she was only 8 or 9 years old. True story. Edwin Franco Goldman was born on January 1st of 1878 in Louisville, Kentucky. He founded the New York Military Band in 1911, later known as the famous Goldman Band. The band played in many summer band concerts throughout New York especially at Columbia University, and then on the Mall in Central Park. In the 1930s, the band performed three nights a week at the bandstand in Brooklyn's Prospect Park, and was also heard on many radio broadcasts. Tonight, we're going to perform Goldman's Wisconsin March. Again, remind you that if you have not already done so, if you'd fill out the slips at the door, we can add you to the mailing list or the email list, and you'll receive regular communications from the band. We'd be happy to add you to our list.
Take a couple minutes to recognize some people who've been very important to the band. First, this gentleman was a founding member of the band back in 1987. Unfortunately, his instrument was the violin, and there are no violins in the band. So he was named first chair announcer and has occupied that slot for 30 years. We would like to recognize Tom Dowman for his service to the band, behind the scenes, and behind the mic. Second, we are losing one of our board members after this concert. Karen Martin and her family are moving to Texas. She's been the vice president of the board for 12 years and is also an integral member of the clarinet section and the Dixieland band. We will miss her leadership, musicianship, and most of all, her friendship. Her son Eric will also be leaving the bass clarinet section. Karen and Eric, please stand and be recognized. Aside from Tom Dowman and Terry Hathaway, there are several original members of the band still playing. Diane Furgit, Karen Royan, Dottie Dowman, Mary Morelli, Mark Hable, and Dana Hartel. Would they please stand and be recognized? And last but certainly not least, I would like to invite the mayor of Oshkosh, the Honorable Steve Cummings, to come forward for a presentation. Mr. Hathaway, would you please come over here, too?
What a great evening to be listening to this world class band in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. I was just explaining to my wife that bands do not have violins, so I was right. Now is my privilege to do a proclamation for Terry Hathaway. This is very small type, and I have very old eyes. Whereas in 1987, Terry Hathaway became the conductor of the Oshkosh Area Community Band and has continued in this position for 30 years. Whereas on the evening of April 1st, 2017, Terry Hathaway is conducting the Oshkosh Area Community Band for his 30th anniversary concert. And whereas Terry Hathaway graduated from Oshkosh High School in 1965, received his bachelor and master's degree from the University of Wisconsin-Oshkosh in 1969 and 1975, respectively. And whereas Terry Hathaway has played French horn in the Oshkosh Symphony Orchestra, Oshkosh Civic Band, Appleton City Band, and the Miss Wisconsin Pageant Orchestra. And whereas Terry Hathaway has been a recipient of Who's Who among American teachers on 6 separate occasions. And whereas Terry Hathaway has been recognized for service and leadership by both Oshkosh North and Oshkosh West High Schools. And whereas Terry Hathaway has been passionate about sharing his love of the arts by teaching for 37 years. And now therefore, I, Steve Cummings, Mayor of the City of Oshkosh, do hereby proclaim Saturday, April 1st, 2017, as Terry Hathaway Day in the City of Oshkosh.
This is April Fool's Day.
Mr. Hathaway asked me, they're not going to do anything foolish, are they? Well, let's see, what do we do about what we're supposed to do next? We re-welcome our director. Would you please re-welcome our director? And at the same time, I'm supposed to know that he's not a very good dresser. The job got kind of turned around, sorry about that. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please extend another warm welcome to our band director, Mr. Terry Hathaway. We want to open the second half of tonight's concert with something energetic, so we chose, get this, the finale from the William Tell Overture. Using the 1938 arrangement by Eric Leedson, Terry has edited it down into an abbreviated version. Some of us who, let's say, maybe are the more seasoned listeners, remember this song as what? The Lone Ranger, hi ho, silver, away! Right. Am I dating myself? Ladies and gentlemen, the finale from the William Tell Overture. John Lorge's bio, I know that you know that he is a native of Oshkosh who is currently a professional composer, arranger, director, and French horn player in California. You may have also noticed in the program that it says he graduated from West High School. False, he graduated from North High School. We know because, which one? Right up there. Kenny, stand up. He graduated with him from North High School. Right. Using a book title, Folk Songs Out of Wisconsin, John Lorge selected six melodies and arranged them for the band into this wonderful selection entitled Wisconsin Water Music. We are delighted that John was able to be with us this evening to guest conduct the world premiere of his own piece. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please extend a warm welcome to Oshkosh native, Mr. John Lorge. career performance. How about that? Is that wonderful? This next piece is a very powerful piece of music in a different way. It's entitled The Silent Hills of My Childhood. It's by composer George Farmer. It's a musical depiction of his childhood. Recollections of his mother's stories of her youth in Ireland. The title is from the poem Prayer by Max Ehrman. From the prayer. May I still remember the bright hours that found me walking over the silent hills of my childhood, or dreaming on the margins of the quiet river, when a light glowed within me, and I promised my early God to have courage amid the tempests of the changing years. And now enjoy George Farmer's The Silent Hills of My Childhood.
Thank you.
George Farmer's The Silent Hills of My Childhood. Our next song, our director tells us that according to the composer-arranger Pierre LaPlante, a title, A Cowboy Symphony, is intended to be more colorful and whimsical than pretentious. The first movement is subtitled The Chisholm Trail, and the third movement is At a Cowboy Dance. We hope that you'll enjoy the piece and the accompanying slideshow that goes along with it from the first and third movements of A Cowboy Symphony.
Thank you.
This next piece of music is most unusual, something like you've never heard before. In Mr. Hathaway's notes, it says that machine age was so fascinating that he had to order for the band for tonight's performance. From the first tick, clicks, and clangs of the hi-hat, snare drum, and the break drum, this piece really moves. Relentless rhythmic drive, memorable melodic lines, and unstoppable syncopation all point to an almost perpetual running machine. Although unusual in nature, we think that you're going to find this piece interesting and enjoyable. Enjoy now a really different piece of band music entitled Machine Age. Did you notice that all the percussionists were running about four different instruments at one time? Really different, isn't it? This next one we did way back a number of years ago in our 30-year history, and I think you liked it then, and I think you'll like it again. In the notes it says here, our director says, 3 years is a rhythmic adaptation of a famous old vaudeville routine originated by Tom McNaughton in 1911. 60 years later, Paul Yoder took that routine and added a delightful music depiction to the story. The narrator for tonight's program wishes to remain anonymous. This is for your enjoyment, entitled Three Trees.
know the concert's running a little long, so I'll make this very quick. I wanted to tell you why we're playing Happy Times March. Last fall, I had announced to the band that this concert was going to be my final concert as director, and I was going to move into the horn section and start playing French horn instead and be an associate director and direct a number once in a while. And we got around to January, and I had to inform the band that I was a little embarrassed, but I had to rescind what I said because I was just having too much fun directing the band and I wasn't going to give it up yet. So therefore, we're playing Happy Times March because this group is a happy time for me.
Join us, meet the musicians, meet our guest musician, and enjoy the refreshment. Number two, to Tom Hansen and the whole auditorium crew, we thank all of you for your assistance in putting on this program. All these experts, super job. Change of order. Reception is in the old room. The old room. Same way out, right opposite us on the other side. The old room, just follow the crowd. The reception is in the old room, not at the corner. There'll be people at the corner to point the way if you end up that way. But it's in the old room. Number three, Gretchen Herman for designing our posters and our program cover. We think it's most unusual. There it is. Right up here on the screen. Nice job. Number four, our Dixieland band for their pre-concert performance. Great job. Number five, our stage band just before the intermission for the big band music. Number six, in addition to our friends at WOSH, we want to thank Oshkosh Media, WOCT 101.9 FM, And Oshkosh today is seen on TV Channel 2. We want to thank them for many impressions on behalf of the band, and we thank them for that coverage. Number 7, a long list of donors published on your program. It was listed in the Oshkosh Northwestern on 2 different occasions. Many of you in the audience have been supporters of it, including many of you that gave in-kind donations. Over the years, many people have helped. I think of the people who helped overhaul the band trailer that we use in the parades, and the people who helped modify the equipment trailer, and in many, many ways helped with different programs that we have done all over the area. Number 8, of course, we want to thank our guest composer arranger, John Lorge, for doing an excellent job on behalf of the band. To all of you, our loyal and faithful audience, we really do appreciate your being here. We cannot have a band concert without you. You are the people who complete the picture. And we do thank you for your support. And many of you are our donors and contributors. Many of you have given in kind to this band. And we appreciate everything that you've done on behalf of this Oshkosh area community band. And thank you, Mr. Mayor, for your presence and your presentation tonight on behalf of our director. Now, get ready. Let me first of all warn you, this ain't quiet. Just in case you've been noticing, the instructions were keep talking until we get the drums in places. We are going to play something big. We figured we needed something big to close off this concert. And so we're going to do it big. Let me warn those of you who are wearing hearing aids, if you're in the band or you're in the audience, turn them down or take them off or something, because you're going to get a boom in your eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please re-welcome to the stage our guest conductor, Mr. John Lorge, who will be possibly think about, right? The finale for the Overture 1812 by Tchaikovsky. Here we go. Reception is in the O room. We'll see you there. Please enjoy the reception.